Hey everybody, I'm Krissy Brown, aka Soleric, and I am originally from Sacramento, California. Right now I currently reside in Minnesota, and I just want to thank you for tuning in to my exclusive interview.
You've been doing music for quite some time now. When did you start doing music?
You know, I originally started doing music as a child. My mother, when myself and my brothers and sisters, we were children, she would rehearse with us because she is also a singer and a music minister right now. And I remember as a kid, she would get us up like the Jackson 5 family when we were kids, and we would do rehearsals because there would be like these competitions at the parks all around the city, and this happened in California, and we would participate in them, and a lot of the awards, we would walk away with the trophies. And so as a kid, I remember us rehearsing our behinds off, and we really didn't have a choice because my mom was very serious about it, and so we would get in trouble if we wasn't, you know, we weren't on point. So that is originally how I started doing music, and since then it's just become a part of me. I actually make gospel music, but with that I feel like I make life music, or music that will speak to a person's heart and their soul. I really want to do music that's going to reach everybody, not just one category. So when I do make music, it actually starts with me. So a lot of times if you listen to the lyrics of my music, I'm actually talking about myself. Because when you do music, you know, you have your own experiences, but there's always someone out there who can relate to what you've gone through. And so usually that's my goal when I am doing music. So I would call it life music, but I am more into the arena of gospel because I love to speak about things that God has done for me, things that He's brought me through. And so that is really the foundation of what my music is all about. But when you hear it, you will hear it. It'll sound like life music because they're everyday issues that people go through, not just Christians, but anybody, everybody. It's for everybody. I would describe myself as an artist as being out of the box. I am not afraid of, you know, jumping outside of myself, trying new things, and just being open. I don't want to be caged in. I don't want to be limited because I feel like the gift that God has given me, it is for outreach. This is something that I do for ministry. It's something that I love. And I'm just liberated in it. I'm free in Jesus when I'm doing my music. So I just feel like, I don't know, I feel like I'm probably like Superwoman when it comes to doing my music, because I'm not gonna just be caged in. I'm not gonna look one certain type of way. I'm not gonna look and be a traditional looking way, because that's not me. And the gift and the vision that God has shown me, it is just so large that it can't be contained. So I'm out of the box, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't really say that you would call me, you know, traditional or contemporary. I really want to touch every base when it comes down to music, you know, while I'm doing gospel music, because I'm planning to be all over the place. So I'm not just in one spot. I'm out of the box, so I'm about to hit everything.
I got a chance to get a quick glimpse of your new music video. It's a really hot video. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your new music video?
Okay. My new music video, it's called You Don't Know, and it's basically about a woman who deals with life issues, in particular relationships, and just not just intimate relationships, but friendships and the like, and just the adversities that you go through in life with the friendships, with the relationships, and how they take a toll on you to some degree. So in the video, it just kind of shows a triumphant person who, you know, overcomes the adversary and the adversity through Christ, because He is the only one that could get you or get me out of the predicament that I was in. And so it just talks about how when you have Jesus, in your life, and when he believes in you and when he backs you, there's nothing that can stop you. There's nothing that can hold you down. You know, not friendships, not relationships, not situations in the world. None of that stuff can stop you. And it just kind of gives you a view of the person that I am on a daily basis, because us as Christians or people in general, you face life every day, and every day you have a new challenge. So it just really represents the person that I am. I'm not pretending, I'm not faking. What you see is what you get. God is molding me, he's making me every day. He's creating me to be the woman that he wants me to be, and he's making me stronger. And I feel like in the video it shows a little bit of like how a person can overcome anything that they go through with the help of the Lord. You know, you may not walk around every day saying Jesus, Jesus, or, you know, talking about I'm a Christian, but the life that you lead will speak volumes. You know what I mean? It's not always just about a look. And sometimes I feel like people try to, they try to put you in a box by the look that you have. But because of that, there are a lot of pretenders walking around. You know, you can be suited and booted up in a suit. You can be having a skirt all the way down to your ankles, but on the inside, you're just nasty. And I just feel like that is not the type of person that I want to be. In every video that I put out, every song that I put out, I just want it to be authentic. I want it to be real. I want it to reach the heart and the souls of men, so they know that, you know, no matter what you're going through, even in your junk and in your mess, you can still come to God. You can still be you. It ain't about you, you know, always trying to be flashy to people and just being like, hey, I'm, you know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that for the Lord. But it's really gonna take, it's really gonna show by your personal relationship that you have in Christ. That is what's gonna shine forth, because you can tell people anything, but at the end of the day, anything that you do in darkness is gonna come to the light. So it's about being you, it's about being real, it's about being real in Christ, and just being cautious of the things that you do, because you don't ever wanna misrepresent Christ. And so my goal is to always make sure that I'm being authentic, to always make sure that I'm being real, and to make sure that I'm representing Christ well. I'm a Jesus girl, period. And so in this video, I feel like you'll be able to see that, because when people look at me, my initial look is what's going to catch people's attention. But then when I begin to open up my mouth and the way that I carry myself is going to speak volumes, because your gifts and talents will take you so far, but it's your character that will keep you there. The reason I decided to keep my appearance more edgy is because that's the person that I am. I'm not a pretender. I want to show people the person that I am on a daily basis, you know, while God is still grooming me to be the woman and the person that he wants me to be, because he deals with me on a daily basis. I am a real person, but I love God with all of my heart, and I just want to do what pleases him. So it would be pretty plastic of me, I feel, if I put something on that I know I really wouldn't wear, or if I presented myself to the world in a way that I know is really not me on a daily basis. I want people to see who I really am, and as God continues to shape me and mold me and make me the woman that he wants me to be, I'm gonna move and change as he changes me. But what I will not do is come out in a way that is fake. I will not go before people, or, you know, God's people, and be somebody that I'm not. The advice that I would give for up and coming artists is to be true to yourself. Trust the Lord in all that you do and keep him first. Do not stop when people tell you no. Don't get discouraged and stay discouraged by the things that people say. Believe in the vision and the gift that God gave and showed you. Work hard, okay? You have to practice. What you practice will become permanent. So be true to yourself. Follow God's word and rehearse, okay? And get around people who are skilled in what you're trying to do. Do not surround yourself by people that are, you know, full of the woe mentality or the attitude that you're not gonna make it, you're not gonna be able to do it. Just trust God. and do what he showed you to do, period. You'll hear a thousand no's, but just keep going as long as God says yes. I want to thank you guys again for tuning in to my exclusive interview. For more of me, you can follow me on Facebook at Solyric Krishana Brown. I'm at Krissy Brown on Instagram, and that's with a K and no I. And then I'm at Solyric on Twitter, and the spelling of that is S-O-U-L-Y-R-I-K. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate you.